number four. Houston is ready to open this one up as they line up for the opening kick. Excellent kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Owls' offense basically predicated on what this kid can do.
The thing I love about this guy, Brad, is just the intangibles that he brings to the table. We've been seeing this guy make plays over the weeks, but the thing that I really recognize is his ability to really lead this football team. When things are going well, he's patting everybody on the back. When things are not going well, he's trying to pick them back up and getting them ready to go. So not only does he physically have the tools, but also I really love the way he approaches the game.
Fires out to his wideout. Tackle made around the 34-yard line. He ran a good-looking route and picked up positive yardage.
That he did, and he made a good catch. That short passing game is where you see all those hours in the summer that you put in pay off.
And he's tackled around the 30-yard line.
If this offense keeps running at this guy, they're going to have to rethink some of their play calling.
And this one is a beauty. Not a great return there.
Boy, he got a hold of that ball. This punter has a big-time leg, and you can see that when he gets a hold of a ball like that. He really goes.
Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. Blockers or running backs got it on the screen, and he hits him hard at the 30. So they pick up quite a few yards on that play, Kirk.
Well, that was an excellent route, and he did a great job of holding on to the football.
He's on the run. They'll bring him down at the 36-yard line.
I doubt anybody will ever mistake this guy for a tailback, but he didn't look too bad running the ball there.
Gets rid of this one. From their own 36-yard line, it's second down. And they get the sack.
A defensive end with this kind of speed is an offense's worst nightmare. He's got the ability to collapse the pocket on any given pass play. And as a play caller, you constantly have to be aware of it. Whether you're going to roll away from him or you're going to chip with a tight end or a running back, you're constantly concerned and aware of a big, strong defensive end.
Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with five wideouts. He airs it out. Caught sideline and he stays in. And the wideout gets a chance to show what he can do.
Oh, he sure does. And he doesn't disappoint either. Great athletic ability.
Completes it, but he can't shake the defense. With room to run, and he's taken down around the 16-yard line. Superb effort by the receiver to come down with that ball.
Well, this comes down to the timing between the quarterback and the receiver, and the result, again, a nice play for the offense.
Quick throw out to the receiver. He's hit and taken down. So they pick up quite a few yards on that play, Kirk.
Well, that was an excellent route, and he did a great job of holding on to the football.
Move and he scores.
A powerful push by the line and a really nice run. That'll get you into the end zone almost every time.
And he tacks on the extra point. A 9-play, 78-yard drive. And the result, 7 points. So the score now, 7-0. Looks like they're ready for the kick. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Houston's in the driver's seat right now, but it's still early, Kirk.
Yep, very early in this game, but you got to love the feel for it as far as they're concerned. They came up with a stop, and then they get points, and right now they're out of the game.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. He's into the open field. And down he goes at the 36. He's at midfield. He's tackled right around the 38-yard line.
That's good for being 26 yards. That makes it first and 10.
Down. Tackle around the 18-yard line.
First down.
Mike's 50. Mike's 50.
And they make the stop at the 17-yard line. The 15-yard line. He holds on to it and gets maybe 2 yards.
That's a nice play there by the sophomore out of the corner. He read the run and stepped up and made a nice tackle.
From the 15-yard line, it's third down. He's scrambling. Quarterback's going to run it, and he's got room to work. There's a very impressive open field tackle.
That makes it first and goal.
Brought down after a nice run up the middle. Now he tries to buy some time. He's taken down at the one. He might not be able to get the pass off. Keeps it, and he's got a touchdown. We'll be tied with the extra point. And he adds the extra point. They line up to kick this one away. He sends this one deep. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Every drive's important in a tie game. I look for both sides to come out with some urgency. Some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
We've got third and 10. Ball on the 25-yard line. Finds his man, and they take him down immediately. This one will be interference, but who's it going to be called on?
That's interference. Offense.
And that was a really well-played series by the defense.
The secondary decided to drop back into coverage here, and there was nobody open for the quarterback to deliver the ball to. Good job by the D.
The defense looks like they're going to send in the cavalry on this one. He punts it away, and it's a great kick. He's tackled at the 29. This is a fun game, and I think we're going to see a lot of interesting football before it's over. And he makes it out to about the 31-yard line. He makes it out to maybe the 33-yard line. We've played one. We get a tie game at 7-7. Back to the action here in the second quarter. It's been a good one and a tight one at this point. Throws it away.
Very stern effort there by the defense. They weren't giving up anything on that series.
He really got a hold of that one. He makes it out to maybe the 33-yard line. They've been like a couple of fighters feeling each other out so far. Let's see if they start to open it up a little bit more now. Fires quickly, and he's got his man. He's pushed out of bounds at around the 50. The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, five wide receivers in the formation. It out to his receiver in a hurry. Tackle made at the 35-yard line. Passes to the wide out, and he can't pull it in.
Now, the quarterback has to be careful here not to leave his receiver so vulnerable like that. He took a licking right there.
From the 35-yard line. Second down. And he's tackled at the 30-yard line. Gives it up the gut. He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line. Maybe a yard on that draw play. That makes it 4-4. Houston could take the lead with this field goal. It has the distance, and he splits the uprights. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. They'll bring him down at about the 39-yard line. Just throws this one away. From their own 39-yard line. Second down.
Hey, we got Mike Fifth, yo. There you go.
Third down.
Mike Six. I'm coming.
Bring down.
Immediately tackled. taken down at the 20-yard line. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Houston is up by three. And they push him out at the 27. He's at midfield. To the 20, the 10. He's all the way. Touchdown. And he hits the PAT. It was a quick three-play, 81-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
You know, you always prepare your offense to think that we're going to have some success. These guys kind of are coming over the sidelines after touchdown, saying, man, I didn't expect it to be this easy.
And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Rice has gotten the play out of their quarterback, and you expect that that was going to happen, but I mean, what is happening here? Somebody else is going to have to come to the forefront or this thing's going to be over.
If you would have told me before the game that this quarterback would have played like this through the first quarter and a half or so, I would have thought this team would have been leading this game. And you're right. Something has got to happen where his teammates, the rest of this group, they've got to raise their game if they want to have any chance of winning this game.
That'll make it second and four.
Play action here. He's going to scramble. And he tackles him hard at the 37.
That's a D-6. That makes it first and 10.
Gets out to around the 45.
Gain of 8 on the play. That makes it second and 2.
They try running left. Nice run, and he's brought down.
Game of 6 yards. First down.
Three down. Mike's 50.
To him before he could get back to the line.
If these defenders continue to exploit the O-line like that, it's going to be a long day for this running back.
Third down, and they need to get it down to the 39. Fires it out. The defense didn't stop the pass, but they stopped him short of the sticks.
And that's the important thing here. Allow him to make the catch, but make sure you tackle him before he gets to the first down marker.
And they can make this a one-possession game with this kick right here. It's got the distance, and he got it.
You know, I was wondering if he's going to get a chance to kick one of those. We saw him warming up from 60 yards before the game.
17-10, Houston. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. This offense just torched the defense through the air with a great passing attack on their last drive.
I love to watch a quarterback when he can really get into safe with his wide receivers. These guys have worked all week on their preparation to attack this defense, and right now, it's really paying off.
Second down, 10 to go.
Ball on their own 25.
Houston is up by a touchdown. And now the ball is loose. The offense falls on it. Wow, very close to turning it over, but they'll keep possession of the football.
Way to play heads up out there. That's just one more reason to play to the whistle.
Rice will take their second time out of the half.
You know, that's a pretty good effort here by the offense to be able to pick up some yards on the ground, but they come up a little bit short, and it's going to set up a fourth down.
And they're coming after this punter. Oh, excellent punt. Brought down at the 33-yard line. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. He's on the run, runs with it, and he's got room, and he's taken down around the 48-yard line. He scrambled. Now he's going to run, and watch out, slides down.
That makes it second and two.
Now he's scrambling. And down he goes around the 35-yard line.
That's a gain of 9 on the play. That makes it first and 10.
Alert, alert, alert!
He's going to try and scramble. And he's going to call his own number again. He's tackled around the 25-yard line. So they decide to bring the kicker out to try to get 3 points before the half ends. It's up, looks long enough, and it's good. It's halftime, and we've got a close one. 17-13, Houston.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half.
Perhaps the most important statistic in any football game is turnover margin. I once had a wise coach tell me that the football was so important they named the game after it. Whatever that means. I think it means that you're not supposed to let it get away from you and give it to the other team. And so far, both of these offenses have done a great job of that.
No doubt. And most games are lost, not won. And it's because of the turnover differential. And you can look at the stats when you say that every single time. But, you know, both teams doing a good job taking care of it. Both offenses executing and still calling a game, still scoring points, still putting up good numbers, but at the same time taking care of the pigskin. And they better value that thing because, yeah, you give it away and bad things happen.
Looking forward to seeing this second half. I think there's certainly a want for victory.
A want and a need for victory. Some teams need this victory, Reese Davis.
Want, need, got to go get it either way if Brad and Kirk are there to deliver.
All right, Reese, David, thanks, guys. Just about set to start the third quarter. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
It's a new possession for this offense, so what will it hold?
Houston is up by four. Feeds it to the back. Nice run up the middle. Run up the gut. Picked up a first down on that carry.
Yeah, a good job up front by the offensive line. They picked up some nice blocks to allow that back to get in there for some extra yardage.
Quick pass. And they make the stop around the 50-yard line. Run, run, run.
And the booth is going to take a few looks at this to see whether or not the ball came out before he was down. So a big momentum shift could be in the making here as we take a look at the possible fumble.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field is reversed.
So the booth and the referee agree. The runner's knee was down.
That was still a close call, though, Brad. Even though he was down, this guy has to do a better job of holding that football.
Complete, brought down, nothing doing. Houston holds a four-point lead. He gets rid of this one.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
Caught out of the open. Brought down to 37-yard line. Rid of this one.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 37. Gets to about the 37-yard line. Yard line.
That brings up second and goal.
Houston is up four. That's a 3-yard pickup on the option.
That's good for gaining 3 yards. That makes it third and goal.
If they can get it in here, it'd make it a two-score game. It's third and goal.
Hey, check Mike 57. Mike 57. Set. Hot. Hot.
Touchdown, Houston. And he adds the extra point. A 14-play, 68-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points. So the score now, 24-13. Excellent kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Positive yardage. A nice option play. The tailback gets 6 yards before he's brought down.
Let's go one more. Mike six. Mike eight.
The lineman got a little ahead of the snap count. Here's the call.
False start. Offense.
It's so tough to move the ball forward. Even a 5-yard setback can do damage to a drive.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Second down and 9 to go. Ball on their own 26. And he throws it away.
Great job by the defense at getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
Three down.
Hey, check my safety.
Throws it in a hurry. They couldn't get anything to work, and it will be fourth down.
Very nicely done here by the defense. They did a good job of keeping them in check on their side of the field.
And this one is a beauty. How about the coverage there?
Just a great job there by the punt team to get downfield and make the play on the return man before he could get loose.
Last drive ended with as good a result as you can hope for, and I'm sure they'd like to replicate that here.
So much of the passing game is about the timing between the quarterback and his wide receivers. And right now with this offense, they are in sync, and really the timing and execution is flawless.
Makes it to the 35-yard line. He gains a couple of yards on the carry.
Boy, the senior linebacker's experience really showed on that run. He sniffed it out perfectly and made the tackle.
He's going to come up short. Good tackle. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. Pretty good job by the return man there. You know they'd like to do something a little more than they did on their last drive when they had to punt the ball away.
If they're going to make a comeback in this game, it's going to have to start now. This offense has to get rolling. The defense was playing run all the way right there, and it paid off for them.
Second and 14. Ball on the 26-yard line. Passes left, gets it out to the halfback. He's taken down at the 34. What a throw for a big gain.
That is a great example of the quarterback seeing the whole field and finding the guy who had the best chance of making a catch.
He's scrambling, and he's going to come up with a sack.
Boy, this pass rush is sometimes scary. They're really getting after the quarterback now.
Booming kick. And he's taken down at the 31. Not much luck the last time this offense had the ball. They'll bring him down at about the 29-yard line. So with one quarter remaining, Houston in front, 24-13. All right, we're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter. Throws out to the back, and he can't hold on to it.
Number five, the intended receiver on the play.
That brings from their own 29-yard line, it's third down.
Here we go. Check, check. Fox two, Fox two.
There's a strike complete. Well, this offense has got to be elated. This is what they had hoped for, a stop by their defense just to give them a chance. He really got a hold of that one.
He's got the corner. He makes it to the 48-yard line.
They'll take over here, ready to start a new series.
He's at the 40, and he's tackled at the 36.
Just a simple draw play there, but they picked up some big yards.
On the delay, tackle made at the 34-yard line. Tries to get out of trouble, but he can't shake the defense. Third down now, and they need to get it to the 26. Screen pass. He's got his halfback. They'll knock him down for a loss. And they can make this a one-possession game with this kick right here. It's up. And he missed it left. No good. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. And he's hit immediately.
That'll bring up second and three. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Less than 3 minutes in the game. Gains his way to the 46-yard line. Gets out to around the 35.
Anytime this guy carries the ball and gets a little space, we could be talking about six.
From the 35-yard line, it's first down. Gains his way to the 23-yard line.
This is the kind of steady, strong drive that coaches love to see. Right now, they're firing on all cylinders.
Brought down after a nice run up the middle. Rice will use their final timeout. Taken down right around the 12-yard line. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 12-yard line. And they got him for a loss. And this play is number 8 on the drive. Nice run there. This one's all but wrapped up. The Cougars get the victory.
24-13. Kirk, go ahead and just give us your reflections on this game.
Houston came out here today and played with the heart and intensity that you love to see in a rivalry game. They should be very proud of their victory because wins don't come easy between these two teams.
That's it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you soon.